up. Hopefully right now it's fine. Don't want you guys ears being blasted by the other things. But the sound pack should be interesting. I'm looking forward to that. I am indeed. I need to do some quick maths, so I will do some quick maths right now. Let me do some quick math. Okay, so this is like 7,600 then. We'll just do that. That works. Okay, so oh, I don't want to get. I want to set. Thank you, friend. I want to get. And then I want to set. Thank you, fuel truck. I appreciate you. Hey, John. How you doing, John Fezza? Good evening, sir. Hope you're well. Hope everything is great for you. Oh, I need to change something. I think this is supposed to go... This? Stand by, one sec. The one thing I forgot to do. Okay, yeah, I think that goes... Yeah, it should be going through this. Right, okay, that should work then. Well, we'll see when I radio check and it doesn't work later. I won't ban Tech because he's a sub. I wouldn't say that that's true considering Tech wasn't a sub for like a day. So I think that's wrong. Just being the typical dead stream... You know, John, you're not a dead streamer. Come on. John, you're not the guy. You're not the guy with the thing on the screen. Guys, don't forget to follow and subscribe. Make sure you fucking sub, dude, or I'm banning you. No, literally, like, I try to like go into different streams, like in Flight Sim, and there's like people that put like scrolling text about them, like, don't forget to follow. Like, in the middle of the screen, though, it's not even like at the top. It's like covering like one third of the screen and I'm like, are you serious right now? Okay. Sorry, bro. That is not what you do, my friends. That is not the way to greatness, friend. Or even the way to the beginning. I mean, people are gonna do what they're gonna do and that's their business, but like, don't do that. Just don't do that. All right, we got passengers in here now. I don't care about cargo because I don't care. Christian. I don't think John's clickbaiting, but I could be wrong. John, are you clickbaiting again? Are you clickbaiting again, John? All right. Well, I'll make sure to let him know. Tech? Because Flight Sim, Twitch overall probably doesn't give much of a shit, to be fair. Like. Oh my gosh, John. Lol. And Comet. Comet where? Commenting on Twitch. What? How does that work? Is that like the chat? I don't get it. Feels good, man. Oh, you were a real pilot for British Airways? All right, John. You're out. You're out, John. You're out of here. I have a potato PC. Good evening. How are you? Good to see you, man. It is good to see you. How are we tonight? The 12-year-old's Moncas? Exactly. That's pretty much how I feel. That's pretty much like why I just don't read YouTube comments on videos that aren't mine, because it's like I actually do respond to the YouTube comments on the Process Lasso video when I get those, but yeah. How are you liking the sound pack? Hey, Potato, I literally haven't flown with it yet. I just bought it, so I have no idea. Hey, Paddle. Yeah, man. Yeah, we're doing the BSS today. It's fine because you said sorry, lol. All right, guys, he apologized. It's all good, man. It's all good. Let's turn these up. Oh, apparently the screens are on already for some reason. I wasn't expecting that, but okay. All right, Hey, Moab, it's good to see you, man. I hope you've been well. Welcome back. So paddle, yeah. I've heard 11.26 is a little iffy, so I'm staying on 2.5 because other than the mic popping joke that's referenced in the title, I didn't want to break anything because it seemed like things are running fine. Literally knocking on my desk right now that's made of wood, but yeah. Hey, Cessna. Yeah, sorry about your account, but welcome in. Welcome in, friend. All right, Potato. Thanks for the information, friend. All right, once again. Oh, no, it did work. I fixed it. Oh, wait, did I? Oh, you have to click this and then it... Okay, that makes sense. Okay, I fixed it. I finally got the nav data thing to work. Last time I tried to do it, I did something wrong, but apparently I did it right. Moab, sorry to hear that, man. I hope things are going better for you, but yeah, I'm doing good. I'm glad to be here tonight. So, yeah, should be fun. Okay, so we're gonna get on the network. And I already filed the flight plan, but we'll still go over the SID before I do that. I just filed it early since I didn't want to have to file it in the client, so in game. Because the Pilot Edge client is and X-Plane is good, but I don't like that you can't tab between fields. It makes it take like 3 times longer, so. I pre-filed the SID and such. So let's take a look at that. There it is. Okay, so this is Casper. You know that. That's from when we were getting ready. But so all this really is, this SID basically just takes you to your transition. So we're going to climb to 3,480 and then via the SID or as a sign, because there's no top altitude. It's assigned by ATC. No, not on Ivea today. Yeah, dude, Wonka's real. And we're going to use the choke transition. So yeah, that's pretty much all there is to say about that. Not really much to discuss other than one thing. It's important to look at this really quick, little side note. It's important to remember that you should read, like, even though notice that it doesn't say that, like, so on these Jepsons, it'll like, usually what it'll do is it'll say like the runways next to the top altitudes, but it doesn't do that here. But we know that it's runway 20 only, not just because it says right there, but if we didn't see that at all, that's the climb heading on the initial climb text instructions. So yeah, little side note. That's how we know we can't use like another runway. Hey, Red Fox, what's going on? It's good to see ya. Hope you're doing good tonight. All right, I am going to get on the network now, so stand by while I do that. I just need to change this. All right.
Connected to Pilot Edge.
Okay, so if I did this right, I should be able to hear when I call for clearance, when I turn the radios on, of course. Why do I have no radio, though? There's no radio on the Pilot Edge Helper plugin. That's concerning. That is concerning.
Disconnected.
Oh, and I've just disconnected myself by hitting the push to talk.
Connected to Pilot Edge.
What do you mean, mic on, Ruben? Are you saying you're hearing me on Pilot Edge? That can't be right. I didn't change any of the mic input. I just changed how it's all routed. Why is the screen black? Question mark? Nice one. Why is the screen black? Oh yeah, duh, Ruben. Thank you, duh, okay. I don't know why I'm spacing that now. Thank you, sir. Okay, so the glacier frequency. So we call Glacier Ground for clearance at this kind of an airport. So we'll tune that. Yeah. I was like, what am I doing wrong here? All right, so we put Glacier Ground there and then we put Tower on the other side for later. Okay. So we're going to go ahead and talk to Glacier Ground and get our clearance to Casper then. Also, you guys aren't hearing... Okay, I'm gonna do a radio check to make sure I can hear it. Glacier Ground, Alaska 2050 radio check.
Alaska 2050, Glacier Ground, loud and clear.
Alright, did you guys hear that? And how loud was it? This looks like a pan. I can see the resemblance. How loud was that, or was it too quiet for you? Please let me know. Okay. I don't want ATC to be inaudible later. Okay. Thank you. Like I said, I made some changes, and I need to check them. So, yeah. All right. Glacier Ground, Alaska 2050, IFR Casper, please.
Alaska 2050, we send your flight plan. I don't seem to have it on file.
Alright, roger, we'll resend it, Alaska 2050. I filed it on the website. I don't know what's wrong, but we can do that. That's fine. I definitely filed it, though. Tell me, flight plan filed. I'm sure you've connected with Alaska 2050, but okay. The website bugs out sometimes, so we'll do that again. Alright, sorry guys, I have to do this again apparently, so go like this. Hey Franco, or is it Francoa? Let me know how to say that if I'm saying that wrong. This is the A320, the Airbus A320 by Flight Factor in X-Plane 11. How you doing? Welcome. Alright, I need to get the routing pasted again, or put it in again. It's not long, so I'll just type it. If it was longer, I would paste it, though. Okay, flight level's the same. True airspeed's the same. I think I put... what did I put for this, though? I don't remember. I put Billings, I guess, is fine. Yeah, that's fine, whatever. It's like 230 or something, or 245. Alright, we'll try that. Could be just a bug with how it sent. Spar attack. I didn't get told off. Come on. Wait, John, you file it you file it in two places? Why? Alright, I guess it doesn't really matter. Hey, Andrew. You do you, man, alright? I'm not gonna question. Hey, Ben. It's good to see you, Ben. How you doing, man? Good to see all you guys. Alright, we'll try this again. Glacier Ground, Alaska 2050. Let us know if that worked. Hey, Mike. What's going on? You know, I could do that. You're not wrong. I could do that. I didn't think about it.
Alaska 2050, good to Casper Airport. Kalispell 1 departure. Chode transition. That is filed. Climb via seed. Accept. Maintain flight level 230. Departure frequency 133.4. Squawk 6344.
All right. Alright, cleared to the Casper Airport via the Kalispell 1, choked transition, then is filed, climb via the 617 flight level 230, departure frequency 133.4 and squawk 6344, Alaska 2050.
Alaska
Goose?
2050 is
that correct? Goose, I use Matt Davies 1.3. It comes with PTA. So if you download the newest version of PTA, it's the included preset. I know that sounds weird, but yeah, that's what I use. That's what I've been using for a while. Although he told me that he has a different version of it, but I didn't need to get it from him. Like, he made a better version later, and that's just the one that's packaged with it. So I need to message him anyways, or if he comes in, then I can just ask him to send it to me. Because Matt does come in from time to time. All right. Yeah, this is Flight Sim World, actually. You caught me. All right. Show's over. So we are going to put this in now. So we're going from Kalispell to Casper. Need Chili FSW? True, except Matt did that already. What do you mean, Ruben? What do you mean I allow him in? What kind of question is that? No. I don't get it, man. No, I don't allow him in. He's British, the enemy. Oh, okay, you're one of those people. You're like that guy from, you wouldn't probably get the reference. Maybe you would. If you've seen the show Wait Till Your Father Gets Home, there's this, like, guy, I forget the guy's name, but he's, like, he's always, like, conspiring about, like, people trying to take America over or something. It's like a 70s, like, cartoon.
Hello, Mountain United, 241's ready to copy to San Francisco, IFR with Yankee.
It's, like, the same people that,
United 241
and
the Colonel
Greening
include to anyway. San Francisco Airport.
I know, random.
E1C departure. Course transition. Then
okay, so
we're going to align
on reference.
Climb the AC. Departure frequency 119.2. Squawk 6153.
No, I don't want to talk it, thanks. I'm good.
Curtis San Francisco, P-Vine 3 departure. Cruds transition. Then as well, I'm going to say departure of 19.
I like the VHF 19.2,
so squawk 6153, United 241.
I'm going to do this. One sec.
United 241, made it back correct, expect runway 34 left.
United 241, retro.
Alright. We should be good. Can you turn on ATC? Yeah, I'm gonna work on that. One sec. I'm gonna turn down the, sim, I think. Okay, I don't want like that. I want everything else like this. Or I'll just do this. I think this is easier. Oh, wait, I can do that too, right? So, yeah. Duh. Okay. I didn't realize the Aerosoft doesn't do that, so I'm forgetting that you can do that in this plane. Thanks, John. Yeah, I forget that the Aerosoft, well, I was like, the Aerosoft volume doesn't do that? Oh yeah, this isn't the Aerosoft. This is not the Aerosoft, friends. All right, nothing new. Chili taking an hour to get to the runway. Nothing new, boys. Did you block him, yep, it is me? Did you block him? Are you that pissed off? Hey, Andrew, no worries, dude. I understand. Thank you for the 5 bits, dude. Take care. Have a great rest of your night. We'll see you later. Do appreciate that. It's kind of an X-plane thing. Integrated with a... Oh, okay, I got you. All right, let's do this. If I can do that... X-plane growing pains, the camera. It's not bad, it's just this weird thing with like the camera sticking when you try to move. Okay, so this is 52, I guess.
Another whiskey contact cascade approach, 124.3.
26.8. It seems a little low. Let me just double check that I did this right. Okay, it all looks fine. I mean, that looks normal, but I was just making sure I actually did it. Okay, I said block was 7.6. Around down here. Okay, so GPS primary means it's a line. Thanks, Ruben. True. True, man. I see what you're going for there. I see you, dude. Alright, so we're gonna set the altimeter. The... Kalispell altimeter, if I can grab that, is 29 or 85, so we'll set that now. Hey Wolfie, how you doing, man? It's good to see ya. Oh, I'm in toga power because of the bug when you start the flight factor. Yeah, I keep forgetting about that.
Left, taxi via
that's
alpha.
That bug where it loads in with the throttle forward.
Advise, we have water.
Yeah, I had the throttle back, but it's a bug, I guess.
Okay, 3-4 left, Alpha Cross 2-5, and I missed
it's not major, but if you didn't notice, it would be awkward, right?
2-41 advised when you have Reno weather.
All right, so we're going to put Project Fly in now.
Yeah, we've got Yankee United.
So I'll take just a second. This is Glacier going to... Chili loves Satoga and on the stand. I know you're laughing, but I'm serious. It's actually a bug. Like, someone told... Like, I asked about it, and they were like, yeah, it's a bug. And it might have been by they. It was, like, someone who's flown this thing a lot in the sim, so... But anyway. These... Okay, interesting. All right. So, done and filed. Yeah, paddle. It's funny though, right? It's like, it's not on purpose, but it's almost like a hidden, like, hey, you need to be paying attention, you know? I don't know. I wonder how many people have gotten like screwed over by that. Like they just are like, oh, well, my throttle's back IRL. Why would it be forward? I don't know. See, I didn't update the flight factor, John, because like I'm on 11.25 and so far everything's running okay. I just didn't want to do anything to potentially do anything stupid. Cause like you guys tell me like when updates and stuff like that sometimes are irrelevant. What's a checklist? Yeah, true. What is a checklist? I always do this. I always click takeoff, but I have to do the flight plan first. I don't know why I do that. Airbus flow memes. Okay. So runway 20, we're Glacier. The transition, just check that. Okay, it looks good. From there, we want the, we're not doing an arrival into Casper. We're doing a fix or a waypoint. That's going to be, I think it's called, I wanted to make sure I spelled it right. It's with an X, not another K. All right, so then we insert that. There's no anything here, but we'll leave the disco because it's not really relevant for a while. Don't want to pay for X-Vision. You know, I'm all like, okay, I've explained this before, but quick little sidebar. I'm fine with like paying for something that's relevant, but I don't know. I feel like it's a little bit fast to like tease that and then just already like pull the freeware plug on it. I don't know. I don't know if you guys know what I mean by that. Like, I feel like what they should have done is they should have like made it donationware, but I don't know. I don't know how donationware like works in X-Plane in terms of like how successful it is, like how many people actually contribute. I have no idea. Oh, and yeah, there's that too. Like, who knows if it will work? I mean, I'm not saying like that any which way, but yeah, I mean, I don't know. Well, 11.30 is probably far away. Hey, Anna, how you doing? What's going on? Welcome in. Glad to hear you're doing good.
Just
getting ready to, get going in the
A320
here. We're going to go to Casper
in X-Plane. Wind 290 at
18,
gust 24. Clear takeoff 3-4 left at 241.
And this is up 0.5. Oh, it needs to be slash. That's why. There we go. Flex TO. Yeah, that's fine. And then goose. Yep, you got it. That's what I am. Oh, awesome. Yeah, Aerologic is cool, right? Where are you headed? Are you going to Tampa? Yeah, fly Tampa. Tampa is, yeah, it's good. Let's play Fortnite. That's what I'm saying. You know, we should just stop flying with ATC and we should just take off and play Fortnite. Instant popular chat, Kappa. Not really. I actually, like, I make fun of Fortnite, but I and like I do that because, okay, the reason that I started making fun of it on stream mainly was because of that ViewBot meme that came into chat. Like, if you all weren't there, like, little side, that's why, like, that's where that came from, was like people, like that whole deal. That's why I even started really doing it. I mean, if you like Fortnite, and a lot of people do, that's great. And I have nothing against that, but I just thought it was so weird to have like ViewBots talking about Fortnite. I'm like, I don't do that. I don't do that, dude. It was interesting. That's what that was. Yeah, it was. Yep, it's me. That was when I was doing it.
United 241, Oracle departure, ready to contact.
That was when I was doing it. You are correct. You are correct, friend. Okay, yeah, bear with me on my flow time here. But it's better than it used to be, I think. A little more talking. So, this. And then we want fuel pumps on. And, oh, another reason I didn't update the flight factor is because I read the readme for the sound pack, and it says, like, not to update right away because it might break the sound pack. So I didn't want to, like, take that risk because then I knew I would be late. Like, if I broke the sound pack because it was, like, you know, out of date or something, and then, you know, I'd have to go back and fix it. I didn't want to do that. Like, I'd have to go back in and put the other version of the plane. No. I'm gonna say, I knew there was another reason why I didn't update. I just couldn't remember what it was. Okay, so we're gonna start the APU now. There we go. We'll get that going. Yeah, the TBM is pretty cool. Like, actually, though. Like, it's a pretty cool project that he's doing. So, I think it's going to turn out to be pretty good, honestly. Like, I don't really doubt it. Hey, golfing. No heavy? I know, right? Yeah, this is FSX A320. You were 6 minutes early. You could have utilized those 6 minutes to see if it worked. I'd rather be 6 minutes early than 6 minutes late, because that's what it would end up happening if I had to try and fix something else, which does happen sometimes. Captain Obvious, what's up, dude? Capper! Hello. How are we? Is this Aerofly? True. Yeah, this is Aerofly. I mean, okay, Aerofly is like... We can talk about this more in cruise, but like, Aerofly is a cool simulator. It's just like, there's some things that it has really, really, really astonishingly good, and there's some things that it lacks in heavily. Hey, what's going on, Brian? Good to see you. Hope you're well tonight. Alright, so let's... get rid of... Ooh, I did it again. Don't need the sunshade. Okay, APU gen should be on, so I should be able to shut off the GPU so I don't have a disconnect like I did before when I flew this. Before when I flew this, boys. Hey, Capper, I'm glad that I can do that for you, man. Yeah, I hope you're doing all right. Capper, I'm sorry, man. Yeah, I hope I can make your night better, though. Sorry, I missed your other message. Trying to get through flows here. Okay. All right. Plane is alive. That's good. Yeah, I love when I take that out and, you know. I love when I take that out and, you know, how that works. What's going on, Mick Rich? How you doing? I'm going to turn this off. Hey, golfing. The fly factor is, the fly factor is honestly, like... One sec. Moving on. Moving on, friends. Sorry about that. All right, so that should be it. So let me explain how Casper works, right? Ooh, what? That sounds so good. Ah! Dude, I already know I'm gonna like this shit. This is gonna be good. I'm like, rip my $20, but you know what? Maybe not. Maybe not, dude. Also, your ban emote is actually good, John, by the way. It's actually not bad. So, by the way, this Casper is from the Scenery Gateway. It doesn't look bad, but anyways. Or Casper, I'm sorry. The Glacier Park is from the Gateway. But, so this is all non-movement, so we basically push our discretion. Then we talk to ground afterwards. So hopefully we can push without the memes. See what happens. Yeah, Anna, like the flight factor. Hey, John Fly, thanks for doing our push tonight. Mr. John Fly. Did any of you guys see John Fly playing golf or whatever? I didn't watch it because I was doing other things, but did you guys watch that? No, this is better pushback golfing. It's way better. This is X-Plane. But we need better pushback for P3D so bad or something like it. Yeah, pushing the right way, poggers. Yeah, that's what happens when you can actually see. Like, I know what you're thinking, like, well, you should just memorize, but sometimes it's, like, actually kind of confusing. It, like, isn't necessarily obvious. Because it doesn't say, like, north or south. It says left or right, but, like, whatever. The right way. No, bad pun. Tug going through fence? Yeah, I know. Pretty much. Pretty much. But same thing happens in P3D, so, hey, Pitoin! How are you? Good to see ya. Hope you're doing
okay. All doors and hatches are closed, ready to connect.
All right, so they are connecting. My immersion. Yeah, Potato, I'm looking forward to it. You didn't log in on Project Fly because it's a short hop. I log everything in, like Anna, the only time I don't is when The only time I don't log everything is when it's a, like GA. Sometimes I won't, but sometimes I still do. Potato? I guess. I didn't really want to pause, but okay. It's fine. We're not flying yet. If I was flying yet, definitely no. But keep in mind that, like, this also depends on your slider, like, okay, I guess you're just gonna have to screenshot that. I don't know why I was trying to give it to you, like, you were in Discord, like, I don't know. I can't, like, copy-paste images directly to chat. I would have to use, like, Imgur or something, and I really don't want to do that right now, but yeah.
So, connected and bypass pin inserted. Release parking brake.
All right, so we're gonna push now.
Starting pushback, and you may start engines.
Hey, thanks, John. I will start the engines, friend. Thanks for the help. I appreciate it, dude. When am I gonna get my... I need to get my voice in. I feel like my voice isn't good enough for better pushback, though. I don't have that, like... You know, that, like... What is it? The gumption? I don't know if gumption's the right word. It's like... Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if anyone would like hearing my shitty ass voice and in better pushback. Man voice? Yeah, thickness. Not teenage girl voice. Yeah. Your voice is thick, my boy. Oh no. Alright, here we go. Alright, so I need to start the engines now. Probably should do that, right? Here we go. Oh, hey Durka. Thanks for that auto host. Hey, Anna, no worries. Take care. Thanks. All right. So apparently the engines are good. Also, that wasn't really loud, right? The notification was okay, guys. Oh, wing view. How do I do that? Wing view? How do I get a wing view? Do I need wing views? Oh, that's pretty nice. That's what you mean. All right, let me do this. Yeah, that's what it is, but... Oh, you can't set it up inside X-Plane?
Operation complete. Set parking brake.
Yeah, I heard you had to edit the preferences file, but I don't know where it is. Go into cabin? How do you even do that? Can you go through the wall? Oh, like this? You mean like this? No, open the door. Okay. Oh, is that really loud? How loud was that? Hey, King, what's going on? It's part of the VC. So I unlock the door, which is, if I knew this layout enough, I would do it, right? Oh, you guys are saying to open it like this. Okay. Wait, it isn't open. Center console, but it's not clickable. What are you talking about? You can't open it. You guys all just fucking baited me into trying to open it. God damn. Feels good. Feels good, man.
The ground, Alpha 4 taxi for a...
Oh, this feels slow. Yeah, I'm a noob to X-Plane. Sorry, friend. Hey, Rick. Thanks for the, okay, thanks. Yeah, where's the wing? Oh, there it is. You mean over here? Like this? You said do engine, but you guys are...
Southwest 8101.
I'm as far as it goes. I don't get it.
127.45.
Doesn't go any further. I mean, like this? Well, I don't need help. It's just like this request is kind of weird. That's all. Said wing view from business. I guess I'm just dumb. Like, I don't understand what you're asking me to do. Yeah, because I don't understand if it's inside or outside. Because you told me to do it inside. But I can't go outside. Yeah, he wants me to move forward, but where? Go to seat one. Well, you said. Okay, this is like way too. Okay, I'm over here. Like this. Right. How is that any different? How is that any different than what I was doing? All right, cool. Jesus. You guys are harsh tonight, bro. I do one for engine two, okay. It's not hard, it's just like, you know, Tech, SkyWest, Tech always has a meltdown. That's kind of normal for the guy. That's kind of normal for him. Kind of always doing that shit. Okay, apparently I didn't have a 4, but that works. Okay, great. All right. So we started one in... Oh, we didn't even start it. What did I miss? What is missing with our... no PSI, huh? Okay,
November,
I never started
it. Whiskey, contact Seattle Central, 121.4.
Okay, I missed something. What was it? What did I miss? You should be able to start it with PAX. I always start it with PAX on and it's fine, so that shouldn't be the problem.
November 8.
I did it last time.
Whiskey, Seattle Central, Uzbek Altimira, 3005.
But, all right. Chili, you don't understand how engines work? Okay. Jesus Christ. All right, we're gonna move on. So. Yeah, I'm like not.
Tow, stand by.
Fuel? But I'm in ignition, right? And there's fuel in the thing, right? Looks like there is anyway. I mean, I don't get it. I have APU on, start available, bleed. This is an ignition. Like, what is missing? He's not banned, he's just timed out, because... Like... I'm sick of getting, like, shit on for nurse.
Hand signal will be on
like,
the
I don't
right.
Get why that's so hard. Like, why can't I just get help without getting shit on? Like, I'm sorry I'm not, like, omniscient, all-knowing. Jesus Christ. Like, people ask me to do X-Plane, and then I do it, and then I get shit on. I'm not gonna do it. You get one or the other. You get one or the other, all right? You don't get both. How much air pressure in the lower E-cam? Okay, I'll take a look, paddle. Thanks. All right, it says no pressure. So what did I do something in the wrong order? Well, Goose, okay, but that's fine. But Pete, aka Fly Purdue, told me to do one first, so I did one first, but I can try it. Okay. That's not a bad idea. Oh. Okay. Maybe. No, I just timed him out. Yep, it's me. Okay, now it's working. There we go. What did I...
November 143, Victor Tango, Denver Center, good evening.
Yeah, that's probably a bug, because, like, I don't claim to be, like, an expert on this thing. I'm not black box, but I also, like, have done this before. Why are you timed out? You didn't get the 5 million bits badge, so you gotta spend your time out. Sorry, friend. So is this where you want me to be, or you want me to be outside? Next time, the easier solution is Control E. I'm tilted. That didn't feel like anything, though. Like, what? I'm not excited by that. It's like starting the 787 engine sounds like orgasm, though. Am I supposed to be outside? I mean, yeah, that's pretty cool, not gonna lie, but I don't know. I mean, I'm not saying it's supposed to sound like a 7.4, don't get me wrong, but you're supposed to be wing view, but I don't hear shit. I'm not saying it's inaccurate. It just feels I feel underwhelmed. You're like, oh my god! Oh! It's like the best thing! It's like P3D5! My dick! And then I do it and I'm like, okay. Good, but alright. That's what I felt like. There was like no, like, I didn't have that moment. I didn't have that moment, okay? I'm sorry. I just didn't feel it. Turn up your sounds? All right. I'm turning them up. All right. You asked for it. All right. There you go. I'm turning it up. All right. Let me know how that one is. Okay, I turned it up, but... You guys are funny. Hey, King Dan. No, this is Flight Factor in X-Plane, man. Yeah, this is the Flight Factor. The Aerosoft is only for P3D and FSX. But the new Aerosoft was for P3D. External. He said not to go outside, though. He said it sounds ass, so I didn't do it. I'm just trying to listen. I'm just listening, bro. What else can I do? I actually don't know how loud this is. The only problem with turning up the sim... Oh, I guess I didn't turn up ATC. No, we're fine. I know I am, Cider, but he told me not to go outside. Ooh. Nice, dude. Nice, bro. Nice one. Perth has been canceled because you wrote Orbex in all caps. Well, you know what, Ben? You're going to have to catch me on this. I wrote Orbex in all caps in my add-ons list. I'm sorry. My B. Yeah, this is the BSS. Yeah, I just bought it because everyone told me to buy it. I was like, all right. I trust you guys. I'm going to buy it. Everyone said it's amazing, so I'm going to buy it. I mean, it does sound good internally. I mean, I'm not even going to, like, question that. I'm not saying it sounds wrong outside. I don't know shit about A320s. I mean, not even going to go there. Yeah, just be like that guy in Matt's chat and just capitalize only the X and Orbex. It's the last thing of each, the last thing in each one. All right, so we should be good now. A little bit of time loss, but I can now see why this guy was disqualified. Pax off, hello. Hey, Pax off. Holy shit, dude. Hey, King Dan. What airline would you fly for? I can't fly for an airline. So I don't really know, because considering I can't because of medical reasons, I didn't think about the question. Feels good. You guys wonder why we have these emotes. This is why. It's for those moments when, you know, things. It's for those things. I mean, we have this one, but that's kind of self-explanatory. All right, let's turn taxi lights on. Value jet, oh God. Nice one. Nice reference, by the way. Nice reference, bro. Thanks, dude. Thank you, dude. Hi, I'm act like I'm 13 and I make alts and yeah. All right, whatever. Dab on the haters. That's what I'm saying. You gotta dab on him. Let's go flaps one. Let's trim this airplane. Let's get on with it. You guys want to see some flying. Damn it, Chili. Why are you so darn slow? Why are you so darn slow, Mr. Chili? Mr. Chibi. Get on with it. Get on with the stream. We gotta arm those ground spoilers. Let's use the TO config thing. The auto brake. And test again. Thanks, Brian. Thanks, Brian. All right, for taxi.
Runway 0 double whiskey, contact cascade approach, 119.6.
all that. Cool. All right, here we go. Let's get taxi clearance from Glacier Ground. We don't change the frequency because it's the same. Thanks, Firewire. I appreciate it. The idea, dude.
November 800 Nautilus, cascade approach. Descend at pilot discretion. Maintain 8,000. Expect visual approach runway 16 right.
I'm going to turn down the sim a tiny bit because I have a feeling that I'm not going to hear Mr. Eugene well if I don't do that. So let me just do that for now. And yeah.
Eagle Tower, Baron 5 by Felicity. About 10 miles to the south and down for.
The future is.
What's it
goes? TV in the background, my immersion. Oh no.
Baron 5954 Whiskey Eagle Tower and Tower Downwind to runway 25. Report midfield, altimeter 3016.
Left downwind 25, looking at midfield, perfect.
Glacier Ground, Alaska 2050s at the terminal, ready to taxi with Juliet.
Alaska 2050, Glacier Ground, runway 20, taxi via Bravo, cross runway 30 at Bravo.
All right, runway 20 via Bravo, cross 30 at Bravo, Alaska 2050. All right, so we'll enter Bravo from here then.
Southwest 8101, descend via the Oaks to arrival.
Ooh, it seems like the rudder pedals make noises, or am I crazy? Is that what that is? Ooh, that's kind of neat. Kind of neat, dude. I kind of like that. It's kind of fun. That's my immersion right there. Gotta hear those toe brakes, dude. All right, so we said to cross the runway, so we'll just cross it and continue all the way. Goose? No. Because Spotify pays artists like garbage, so I didn't put it on there. You gotta be a subscriber to download it. Only subs can download new Mike Pop single. King Dan, you don't need to say no offense. People also say I look like Sheldon, so I don't really care at this point. It's all relevant. It's all relevant.
November 32 kilo traffic, 12 o'clock, don't 6 worry. Miles, opposite direction, altitude indicates 13,000. Roger.
Alright, this is about good taxi speed right here. Should be fine.
Approaching 3.
Hey, Mr.
Zero.
Wise Guy. What's going on? How you doing? Sing me up? Do you spell that sing me up on purpose? Because that's kind of corny if you did. Yeah, below 30? Well, we're going 19, so I doubt we're speeding right now. I doubt we are speeding, friend. Go back to Fortnite, Cessna, come on. Alright, we're done with that. Hey, Sid! I'm playing your simulator, Sid. How you doing, man? What's going on? How is Laminar today? How was it? Did you get any good emails? Time to leave, lol. Feels bad, man. Only hangs out in the stream when I'm not playing his game. Sorry, Sim. Flight Sim is not a game. We did not have fun. Not for entertainment purposes, friends. This is some boring shit. Some boring shit right here. No entertainment allowed. Not fun. Having fun with
November
that.
November 0 Delta Whiskey, flight heading 330. You send the main thing 6,000 to Metro Falcon. Come on.
Yes, the new SOP. Yeah, it's called EULA compliance. EULA.
November 0 Delta Whiskey, you send the main thing 6,000 for now.
No personal consumer entertainment. You gotta scribble that shit, man. White out, whatever you need. Alright, switch it tower, let's get out of here. Let's get out of here, friends. By the way, I think PAX off suits you better. Your name is a backseating meme, which is kind of what you do.
Right,
can I get some shades in the chat? Here we go, boys. Have some fun. Let's have some fun. I'm looking forward to it. Let's hear some sounds. Maybe we'll get Chili-gasm in the making, but we'll see. Because I don't know, man. It's hard to say whether I'm gonna love this or not. You also might, your ears might get murdered too, so you might want to prepare for that one. All right. One more thing. All right. Looking good. And Glacier Tower, Alaska 2050 is holding short runway 20 Bravo 1, ready for departure.
Alaska 2050, Glacier Tower, runway 20, clear for takeoff. Wind 240 at 10.
20, clear for takeoff, Alaska 2050. Alright, here we go. Also, I do have front seat time. Mr. Packoff, but thanks. Thanks for the compliment, friend. I do have front seat time, though. Thanks, friend. Front seat and back.
Approaching 20.
Best of both worlds, friend.
Sorry, for what's your check?
Baron, that's 5 for whiskey, I don't care.
Wind check.
On runway 20.
Wind 260 at 8.
It's fine, boys. It's just cats. What is that wind? Holy shit, this wind. Honk ass. Okay, I think that was alright. Might be done.
Alaska 2050, contact Salt Lake Center.
Salt Lake Center, that's 2050. Alright, we good. We good, boys. Salt Lake Center, Alaska 2050, 5,600, climbing flight level 230 on the Kalispell 1.
Alaska 2050, Salt Lake Center, ID.
How do I ID? I don't know how to ID. How do you ID? Oh, there it is. It's like, it's probably on the decaf. Right? Yeah, that makes sense.
Alaska 2050, radar contact 7 miles west of Kalispell.
Alright. Chat's restricted to tier 3 only? True. King Dan? It's chilly wind, I'm bad. Nah, King Dan, you're alright. Bad puns are okay sometimes. They're you know, all right. This is actually kind of gorgeous, though. I'm not going to lie. Best weather add-on? Oh, yeah. I'm supposed to try FS Global Real Weather, apparently. But I haven't tried it yet because I just bought this. Sound pack. And I don't know. So that wind, that could have been the way I was flying that, but it is 10 knots around runway heading, but it felt a little strong. It felt hard to control that. But who knows, to be fair. Okay, let's do that. So we want this. We want that. I was supposed to have these on, but no one knows, right? Who cares? Who knows, boys? Who knows, boys? Yes, they were off. My bad. I'm sorry. My landing lights were off.
November 8, 00 Delta Whiskey Eugene Airport, 1 o'clock and 8 miles, report on site. November 0 Delta Whiskey, clear visual approach, runway 16 right, make right traffic.
Look at subchat, one sec. I gotta make sure I'm doing things right here. Oh, well, we're in good climb. Let's take seatbelts out. We're above 0,000. Okay, everything else looks good.
Brennan 5-4, Whiskey, runway 25, clear for the option.
Okay, I'm not gonna say what I'm thinking, because I don't want to jinx myself. But not having the problem I was having last time.
Straight out.
Oh, really, Tech? Well, I hope you understand that if I ask for help, it's not very appreciated to, like, get shit on for no reason, because, like, that was a pretty reasonable question. But that's the only issue I had. That's the only issue that I had, friend. But it's all good. I don't hold grudges. Jay Krause. Hey, John. I'm doing good. Good evening, sir. I hope you're doing well.
Tower, November 8th, 0 Delta Whiskey, visual 16 right.
So,
November 8th, 0 Delta Whiskey, Jim Tower.
I will say, here's my thoughts on the sound pack so far. And when I make these comments, it's not, oh, I know what a real Airbus sounds like, because I really don't, to be honest. It's more along the lines of, what do I think of it? It's good, I guess. I mean, there's nothing harsh, at least. So that's not bad, I mean. Hey, Captain. Captain Jack, what's going on, man? You're en route from D.C. to Madrid. Hey, that's awesome, man. What's going on? Hey, Captain Jack. Yeah, welcome. Are you on 11.26? Or are you on...
Airport 25 departure. Is in transition. Venice filed. Maintain 7,000.
No, I mean, Tech. It just seemed like it was you because...
18.42.
You were, like, being an ass. And then...
5217.
That guy was, like... And then you were talking about the packs, and then that control came in. It was, like... It was a new account too, so I thought you just made a troll account to, like, ban or, like, evade the timeout. So yeah, but thanks for clarifying that. Yeah, I mean, 2872 Alaska 2050. All right, so we'll check in with. Go standard too. Okay. Salt Lake Center, Alaska 2050, flight level 189 or climbing flight level 230.
Alaska 2050, Salt Lake Center, climbing maintained, flight level
350. Climbing maintained, flight level 350, Alaska 2050. Yeah, so here's what I think. I have a theory. So the problem that I'll get back to chat in a second, but I thought about something just now. I think what's going on with
November 2 Kilo Quebec, descend at pilot discretion, maintain 9000. Pueblo Altimira to line.
I think what's going on with the mic popping in. So what I think happens is there the ortho that I have around Seattle is also loading along with the photoreel that's like also at Druzeki Seattle, because there's, so for those of you that don't have Seattle Airports for X-Plane yet, there's basically four options in the installer, and one of the, and there's like two photoreel on options and two photoreel off options. I don't remember what the other one is, but it's relevant. The point is, I think what I did wrong is I shouldn't have installed the photoreel with Druzeki Seattle, because it's like, I think it's trying to double load tiles and it's causing problems. Like, I think it's not appearing to be bad, but I think it's loading twice, and I think that's causing the problem. Like, loading that all that scenery at the same time is causing the mic to do that, but I don't know. It's just an idea. Duns, the A320.
Southwest 8101, contact local approach 120.95.
Oh, I don't doubt it, Ben. I mean, like I said, I don't know. I don't know anything about, like, Airbus sounds, really, to be honest. I'm not one of those people, so this might be weird. Overall, I'm not one of those people that, like, goes and watches a lot of airplane videos. I mean, I do, like, I'm not a big YouTube person. Occasionally, though, I will watch, like, Corporate Pilot Life or something. But I don't, like, I'm not that person that, like, hovers my sidebox.
Parking the Alpha 7, Golf, remain the frequency, have a good night.
I don't watch a ton of videos, but there are some cool aviation channels, don't get me wrong. I think there's a lot of cool stuff on that side pre-recorded that you can't really offer on Twitch just because of the nature of live streaming requires things that are kind of prohibitive, like internet to be stable. That's an issue.
That was 8101, Oakland Altimeter 3002. Advise when you have the weather.
Let me see what I missed here.
Expect ILS runway
3. I forgot to turn on the chemtrails. Hey, Firewire. Yeah, man. Yeah, dude. Yeah, John. I had a question for you, John. J Cross. Are you... did
November
you get
one, Whiskey Charlie Jackson Ground Greening,
the,
airport,
what's it called,
Alpine,
the new Carinato plane that John Fly was flying? I forget. I think you, you said you did.
Bye-bye.
I was just wondering.
Direct
yeah,
Mighty Mountain, good. That's Delta Yankee.
Yes, it does
direct.
Sound good.
Climb VA seat, except maintain 15,000.
It does sound good.
Expect 17,000, 5 minutes after departure. Departure frequency 133.25, squawk 2456.
All right, sucks for us that got X-Plane. What do you mean, Wolfie? You can't stop the update. What do you mean? Like Steam tries to auto update it. Are you sure that the X-Plane install? So, Wolfie, you know the X-Plane installer? Like, I'll show you what I'm talking about. If you go
number
to
one,
we'll
get you
this, right? I won't open it, but this, you can't use this to go back to like a non-beta. Is that not a beta update? I don't understand. Hey, Dre Doggin, thank you for that host, man. How are you tonight? Hope you're doing good. Yeah, Tech's a good dude underneath all the trolling. I can believe that. I mean, yeah, I can believe it. Corporate Pilot Life is poggers. You know what I love about their videos? Yep, it's me. Like, I'm not saying that it's not good to have, like, you know, the personalities of, like, you know, like, I think Fly Chops makes great content. I think, you know, Steve-O makes good content, whatever, right? Just examples. Just the first things that come to mind. But the thing I like about Corporate Pilot Life, it's good sleeping videos. Like, it's super relaxing because it's just like the chatter and like the scenery, you know? Like, that's kind of cool, right? I really like that. I should talk in voice more, like with subs or something, or what?
November,
I mean,
thank you. Advise when you have a Canon City weather and when able to say approach request.
Tech, nice one. Like, there's good general aviation content and good, you know, jet turboprop flying content, but like only having like the chatter is really cool. It's kind of like listening to live ATC without the, you know, all the other stuff. Don't listen to Chili if you're on Steam. Just said I wasn't telling him to run the installer. I was just wondering because I don't have Steam. I was asking like how it works. Well, Sid, what I think, doesn't 26 break X Vision though? I'm just asking. Oh. Yeah, Wolfie. I mean, you could... Can't you turn off auto updates? You can turn off auto updates in Steam, right? I don't think you have to update it, do you? I thought you could turn off auto updates in Steam for games. It's not like playing a game on Xbox and you have to update it, I thought it was controlled. Well, yeah, Wolfie, I have X-Plane standalone. I've had X-Plane since the, when X-Plane 11 got announced and I bought the pre-release key. So I have the X-Plane 10. Sorry if I was being harsh. Is that a meme? I didn't let my dog lick peanut butter. All right, I wasn't born yesterday. Was not born yesterday on IRL, and I wasn't born yesterday on Twitch. I think you're gone. Sorry, bro. Nice one. Nice one, dude. Not trolling, by the way. Does this game get old? Hey, Jay Griffin. What's going on? Honestly, Jay Griffin, that's a great question, actually. One second. So, the thing is, Jay Griffin, it depends. Okay, one of the things that makes Flight Sim interesting is, different fields. Hey, Captain Joe. Also, is that super loud, by the way? Or is that okay? Or can you guys not hear the alerts at all? Did you guys not hear the alert? I heard it. Did you guys hear that? Or is it not coming through? It might not be coming through at all. Okay, that means I need to fix that later. That's my bad. Okay, Captain Jack. Thank you so much for that Twitch Prime sub, dude. Can I get some chili shades in the chat? For Mr. Captain Jack. Captain Jack, you just unlocked access to 13 emotes, including the famous chili shades, your sub badge, and the perks list below the stream. Thank you very much for your support. If you'd like to join our Discord... Our Discord is not sub only, by the way. You're all welcome to join if you're not in it. But for subs, there is a sub role. You link your Twitch to Discord, tag them, stand by. And you you get access to the emotes in Discord, and you get the role and the role, the text channel, Aviator Crew, and you get the channel and voice as well. So there you go. Let me see. Yes, one drinks chibi ice, yep. Yeah, Tech, that's fine. Yeah, that sounds alright. It's almost a cruise here. Did I miss a call from Eugene, guys? Let's stand by. So,
Jay Griffin.
Are you talking about Air Force Proud 95, Jay Griffin? You're talking about funny videos? That sounds like Air Force Proud 95. Yeah, he makes trolling videos in FSX. Yeah, that's probably what you saw. That's pretty popular stuff on YouTube, his channel. Regards to your question, does Flight Sim get boring? I think anything. Okay, so Jay Griffin, oh, there it is. There we go. I think that there's been a hit single. There's anything I would argue gets boring if you saturate it. If I sat here, it doesn't matter what it is. If I sat here playing, Overwatch. I don't know, any popular game, you would get bored eventually, especially if it's a kind of game an MMO where you just run out of content and then you end up having to play on alts or something like that. You know what I mean? You can exhaust the content of anything or your desire to do something. But I think that Flight Sim is sustainable because the skill ceiling in Flight Sim is super high. Think about it. If you think about it this way, in real aviation, the skill ceiling is infinite, and the skill floor at each stage is high too. It gets higher and higher. So it feels infinite. You know what I mean? Each thing you do gets harder and harder. And Flight Sim has a lower skill floor than obviously it's easier to fly a jet in flight sim than it is in the real world, because there's all these things you have to do first. And I say easier, not in the sense that you know more, but in the sense that the steps to get there are easier. But I think that flight sim, in regards to getting boring, I think anything gets boring. I think that doing different things and flying different places and different aircraft and stuff like that helps a lot, though. Trying not to fly the same plane over and over again. You know, like me when I did the 717 for like 2 weeks straight when I started streaming PTV. Yeah, like that.
November 0 Whiskey Queen to Charlie Yankee Juliet Airport, Eugene 9 departure. Redirect us to all four.
Yeah, we got a bit. Okay.
Maintain 9000. Expect 10,000 5 minutes after departure.
Sorry guys, you probably won't wing.
Departure
view,
frequency,
huh?
119.6. Squawk 5450.
Okay. So what did I miss? Oh, Captain Jack, you fly on Pilot Edge. Sorry I missed that. So Captain Jack, what do you tend to fly in the sim? You said you're flying the 757, right? What's your like most common aircraft? Are you usually in West? Are you in ZLA too? Like, do you have combined or what? Sorry, I feel like there's a lot of cool new people coming in tonight, like Jay Griffin and Captain Jack. Hey Kev, I missed you there. No, they update it. No, you're funny, dude. It's good to see you, Kev. I hope you're doing well tonight.
Delta 47 Portland Ground, runway 28 left. Taxi via Mike Echo Bravo.
So yeah, think you could fly IRL. So if you mean like, could I do? Do you think like do it? Could I do this IRL? Probably not.
November 2 Kilo Quebec, Denver Center.
Would I be clueless? Probably not either. But being non-clueless doesn't mean you're capable.
Advise, we have Canon City weather and approach right. Request.
Yeah, yep, it is me, like, exactly, like, the skill ceiling, like I said, like, or, like, I don't know if it's skill ceiling, I'm kind of adapting that term from, like, other games or concepts, but what I'm saying is, like, the amount of things to learn is, like, endless, and that is definitely one of the things that can keep you going with it. I mean, I will be honest, like, the stream, like, I would still sim if I wasn't a streamer, but I wouldn't probably sim as much, right? Like, I'm just gonna be honest. Like, that probably makes sense, though, right? I mean, I would still sim.
I just wouldn't sim as much.
I'd probably sim a couple times a week or something. I probably wouldn't pay for Pilot Edge, at least combined, without the stream, because I wouldn't use it enough. I'd probably just have, like, yearly WUS or something. But, you gotta have those city pairs, you know? Now Chibi has to fly the 717. Christian, I'm having a problem with the 717. I don't know if it's a problem, but it's a question. Are we going to start implementing failures, NYC? No, not quite yet. We're not quite there. So, for those of you that fly the 717, can I ask, like... So, I'm having a problem with the 717 where, you know, like the trim, like during the pre-flight, you're supposed to trim stabilizers or whatever. Well, I went to do it. Like, I went to do the perf, and it doesn't give you a stabilizer value for some reason. Like, I think I double checked that I'm pretty sure I did it all. All of the boxes or whatever that you can fill in. Because some of them, like, look like you can fill them in, but they're non-functional, right? So, I go and do them all, and then it, like... has the stabilizer trim thing blank, so I'm like, how do I know what to trim it to? And I'm pretty sure that, because I used to fly the 717 like a while ago, and it would give you the trim, so I'm really confused. Hey Max, just guess. I'm trying not to guess. Come on Max, how you doing Max? Excited for the Cirrus, bro? Excited for you, dude. Make sure you send pictures. You don't have to show the call sign, I understand that, but just show some pictures of the cabin, you know?
November Mr. Max. 800, all right. Alpha.
Let's see, what did I miss? I meant flying through the air, not doing much, but the game, so I'm sure there's more
November
to it.
November 3, Victor Tango, descend.
Oh, Jay Griffin, you're good.
Flight level 220, contact Aspen approach 123.8.
Oh, you're a good friend. Yeah, like, I'm losing my train of thought here. Oh, yeah, I mean, Jay Griffin, like, this is, like, commercial flying versus GA flying. There's different types of flying, you know? Like, that's the kind of cool thing about flight sim is you, if you don't care about stuff like this, you can do, you know, you can do, you can do Cessnas, you can do Pipers, you can do helicopters, you can do, you know, float planes, you can do, you know, jets, you know, you can do civilian jets, you can do military jets. But, I mean, military jets is more DCS. There's a little bit of it in P3D, I guess, X-Plane, but the jets are really in DCS for that. Insert Chile A-10s here, Kappa, but...
November 143, Tango, Aston Approach, Roger.
Jack, so
I have
you fly combined.
You send the pilot discretion, maintain 1-6,000.
And the Zeebo. Yeah, the Zeebo's cool. Captain Jack, I haven't tried the Ultimate, and I haven't tried the Zeebo in a long time. How has it changed recently?
Equipped 581, Whiskey Charlie, Salt Lake.
All I know is that they added, like, a tablet and stuff. Yeah, chat's moving tonight. I'm loving it. Interesting flights. Yeah,
equipped
like...
one Whiskey Charlie, at a contact 7 miles south from Jackson,
Seattle, Captain Jack, with the new scenery is really nice. The new Jacky scenery, it's really nice. Wolfie, yeah, we'll get there.
Southwest,
can you see and talk to
him? Contact Oakland Tower, 127.2.
So, yeah, it's Jay Griffin. Do you hear what's going on in the background? The other voice? That's not a random person. That's ATC, right? So, yeah, we're talking to... with ATC. So we'll be, like, doing frequency changes throughout the flight and on the ground as well. But as far as other pilots, like, we can see their aircraft. So, like, if I had someone flying this route with me, I might see him in the simulator, right? Or if, like, I land in Casper and someone followed me, then I could see them land, or I could see them on the ground or whatever. There's also, like, VFR drones, if you will, on pilotage, and they'll, like, show you. They act as, like, traffic that... you know, for VFR training for, like, the mainly, like, the SoCal area or whatever, the Southern California airspaces. But new hit single Comasco, yeah, Mike Pop, I had one earlier so far, but otherwise we've been all right. Yeah, Captain Jack, I get that, man. If you like doing the transatlantic stuff, dude, you do you, man. I just don't do transatlantic stuff, Jack, because I don't do VATSIM, and so I don't see the point of doing it. Like, I probably won't do anything like that without ATC until POSCON. I don't know. We'll see. See how that goes. Hey, the Trotsky. Yeah, the 7-4. Yeah, that's the thing, Trotsky. You can do some kind of silly but cool stuff, I guess, right? I don't know. It's interesting. Tech, what do you mean? The stuff? What do you mean the stuff? The call sign? Yeah, Duffy, the call sign. November 42069er. Yeah, that's the perfect one.
November 800 Delta Whiskey, Eugene Tower, and 16 right at Alpha Tree, with a takeoff. Wind 2087.
Can't get a warning if the circuit breaker's pulled. You can't. You can't, dude. Yeah, Grid J Griffin, it's pretty fun. Hey, Air, good evening. I'm catching up with chat. You guys are doing great tonight. I'm still moving, but this is great. Keep it up, guys. I'm loving it. Can I go on a tangent and say that child naming apps?
Good visual approach to Fremont County Airport. Change to advisory frequency approved. Report cancellation by far. This frequency.
Just Sid, that sounds weird.
November,
that sounds weird.
Quebec, IFA cancellation. Received Squawk VFR, have a good night. Delta 47 heavy, contact departure.
The textures are improved, Christian? On what?
Suppose
oh, the Caronado?
Taxi to parking.
Is it a 340?
Victor,
yeah,
Tango,
well, Jay Griffin, it's not
in
game. So, this is Jay Griffin. If you click the link, it'll open a new tab. So, it's Pilot Edge. So, it's a service, it's a subscription. It's a subscription service for Flight Sim that basically covers the western half of the United States. Not through Canada, just like the western US and California. But they're like two areas.
Delta 47, hey, report on departure. Radar contact.
Hey, K-Fly, yeah, we are flying the A320. It's good to see you. Trotsky, X-Plane 11 better than P-3. Common question. The thing is, Trotsky, like, it's not really about... It's not really about one beating the other. It's some of it, like, Trotsky, if you're asking that because you're new to Flight Sim, I don't know, maybe I missed something earlier from you that would give me context that you're not, but I think anyone coming into Flight Sim should go with X-Plane. There's multiple reasons for that. One is cost. One is... It's easier to set up. Honestly, it is. It's also easier to keep your X-Plane install from being broken by an update if you go standalone, meaning not Steam version, or if you just want to back it up on another drive. Like, you can literally back up the straight X-Plane install because it's not tied to the registry on another drive and then just reactivate it on the other computer. It's great. P3D, you can't do that, though, and it sucks. But it's a trade-off that I deal with. It's fine. But X-Plane is getting better planes, too. Like, I think it's unfair to claim on either side of the fence that there aren't reasons to have either simulator, or that, like, one is so vastly better than
American
the other, because it's just not realistic.
Cross 50 miles south of Spoon.
I think that P3D does things that X-Plane doesn't do yet, and X-Plane does things that P3D doesn't do yet, and I think that's great, and I think it's a good thing. Because there are planes... There are aircraft in P3D that I can't get in X-Plane. I can't get the good 777 in X-Plane. It's in P3D, and I can't get the good 747 in X-Plane. It's in P3D. But the A320 that I want to fly is in X-Plane, right? So it's just an example, but there's multiple examples like this. GA in X-Plane is prominent. It's crazy. There's so many GA aircraft in X-Plane, and there's good ones in P3D too. Like the A2A P51 just came out, for example, right? But yeah, I mean, I think the X-Plane and P3D are both great platforms, and that it's just kind of up to the next few years. The next couple of years in Flight Sim are going to be very important, and I feel like a lot of people don't realize it, but these next couple of years are going to be very important.
Alaska 3577,
Alaska 2050. Salt Lake Center, Alaska 2050, level flight level 350. All right. Well, Max, am I going to fly on PlusCon? I think I'm going to give it a chance at the very least. I mean, why wouldn't I? Like, I feel like that would be a shame, you know? Is there a weather plugin that would work with the Arabask planes? Are you talking about for the Radar Wolfie? I wouldn't know. I would ask Sirius Max about that. Max was a beta tester for the Arabask, and he might know. I don't know much about the DA-62 yet. Leaving PE? I'm not saying I'll leave Pilot Edge. So, Max, here's what I imagine. I imagine a world where PosCon fills the gaps of Pilot Edge, and Pilot Edge is still a good option for always having ATC in that Western US, right? Does that make sense? So, like, if I want to fly from Denver to... Like, if I want to fly Phoenix to Denver... and then Denver to MSP. I fly Phoenix to Denver on Pilot Edge, and then I go to PosCon and I fly Denver to Minneapolis, right? And then I get service both times, theoretically, right? And I think that's potentially really good if it all pans out. There's a tablet in the Zeebo. Yeah, NYC, there is. And it looks pretty cool. Jack, you haven't flown Zeebo in a while. We spent an hour or so getting up to speed the other day. Not too much has changed. Yeah, okay. I didn't think much else had changed. But I just wonder, because Zeebo pushes like little updates like all the time. Like, he updates that plane like crazy. It's cool, though. It's like cool to see that he's worked so hard on that. You know, like, it's important.
Delta 47 Heavy, contact Seattle Center 121.4.
It's part of the viability of X-Plane as a platform, like selling it to people getting into Flight Sim. I mean, like, I don't mean that, like, not having Zeebo would make X-Plane unviable, but I mean is it's very attractive to come into X-Plane, and you want to just get a taste of commercial flying, and you get the Zeebo and you put it in, and it's like, oh wow, like, this is kind of cool, right? And it gives you that taste. It's like that entry point into the payware world, right? I think that's important. Also, Captain Jack, I haven't flown the Ultimate. I've seen Matt Davies fly the Ultimate. I have no idea what the Ultimate's like. I probably should try it to get an opinion on it anyways. but I haven't tried it yet because I have the PMDG 737 and I don't know. I just like when I fly the 737, I just kind of like to fly prepared, you know, but I'm not against flying the Ultimate necessarily. It might be worth it. I do like the VHF radio and X plane. I think it's great. I do. I think that I wish that was in P3D anyway. Justin, probably not. Because here's the problem with thinking about kids when you're a flight simmer, Justin. Instead of having kids, you could just spend more money on your flight sim, right? Kind of kidding, but I mean that goes for anything. But you know, yeah, yep, it's me. Like, it's really hard to say where it's gonna go, but I think shutting it out is, Shutting it out just because something else exists is like not right. Like, think about it this way. If I just shut out X-Plane, like, if I only did P3D because I'm like, oh, like, P3D is like amazing and like I love it, and I didn't try X-Plane, I'd be missing out, right? Like, it's the same thing. I don't see how it's any different. You know, it's just ATC networks instead of.
Delta 47, contact Seattle Center 135.15.
I honestly do think PosCon is going to go. I think PosCon has a lot of potential. I feel like that there's a lot there. I do. I'm not saying like it's not gonna have bumps though. I don't know.
Delta, you don't want realism? Delta, climb and maintain flight level 370.
Then go to FS Cloud. I like the idea of PosCon. Yeah, I mean, Ruben, I just want not VATSIM everywhere else. Well, yeah, Tristan, exactly, and that's fine. Like, I only come into the debate, it's not really a debate to me, but I only come into that because I try to provide useful information for people. Because one of the things that I try to do with this community is, like, there's always people getting into this hobby, right? You know, regardless of whether they want to do GA or not, or, you know, and there's a lot of factors that go into, like, you know, the things that barrier flight sim for people, right? Money, experience. Flight sim is scary. Like, I mean, there's still a lot of things I don't know, but a year ago, I really didn't know anything. And I think that is one of the things, but I think money is arguably a worse barrier, because I think it's not like the people that want to get into flight sim, it's not that they're unwilling to learn, but like when this huge wall of like things that they need is in front of them, it kind of hurts, right? That's one of the reasons that I think X-Plane is just a better introductory platform regardless of like what you want to fly in at the end of the day. So it's just the barriers are lower. I'm not saying that the P3D payware market isn't justified in some ways. Some of the things in P3D are great. I think Chase Plane is completely fair priced, right? It's, yeah, I mean, you're like, oh, it's $40 for a camera. But if you knew how much will go, like how many features there are in Chase Plane, I don't use most of the features in Chase Plane. I don't use the shaking and all the cinematic shit. That's the kind of stuff that like the Sky Lounge does. If you guys know the Sky Lounge, like OMG Edson, that's what they do. I don't do any of that stuff because that's not what I focus on. I think it's cool though. I think that it's cool that all that is there. It's just a very feature-rich app, for example. Like, I think the payware market in P3D is totally justified most of the time. The captain sim being $105 is bullshit. But most of the things, would I argue some things are overpriced? Maybe. Maybe. But I think, you know, that's inevitable, to be fair. No matter what simulator it is, you're going to always have a little bit of that. I don't know. I'm not justifying expensive add-ons, but I'm justifying add-ons that are pricey that are worth it. Like the Flight Factor, you could say is pricey maybe, but I think it's worth it, you know? Yeah, Jack, Ortho? Yeah, I mean, we're going to get Ortho and P3D soon, but who knows when, right? Because, like, the client or the Python thing, whatever you want to call it, is done, but we don't have overlays. So like testing Ortho and P3D without autogen buildings is kind of pointless, because that's one of the main things that drags P3D down. So like to really test it, you have to have autogen buildings working, and you can't do that without the overlays. So we're just kind of waiting for that to move forward, unless it has, and I just am so behind the loop. All right. Yeah, the 787 is so good, Jack. I love the 787. Yeah, Trotsky. Yeah, no problem. Hey, Sharks fan. It's good to see you. Hope you're doing well. Well, no, Max. I'm just like, there's just a lot of gaps. Like, not having, like, having some things along with Pilot Edge, I think, is okay. I think it's could be really good. It's hard to say, though, you know? When POSCON comes, Chibi said I'll fly YYZ Poggers. Yeah, we'll see. Hey, Daz Frickin. What's going on? How you doing? It's kind of a cool name. Are you a P3D or Daz Frickin? Have you tried FSW? Yes, I didn't like it. Download the demo? Yeah, I didn't like it. Oh, yeah. NYC. Daz Frickin, if you go on xplane.com, there's a try the free demo thing. It lets you fly around an X-Plane for 15 minutes as much as you want. You can keep restarting it to test to see if it'll run okay on your computer. And you can adjust the sliders and graphics as well. Because I don't know what computer you have. Just like it potentially save you money in case you can't run it. But if you're running P3D, you probably can run it. I just misunderstood what you meant. There's a fine line between realism and realistic. You know, you're right, Max. I agree with you. You want to get back to the A320? The A320 is... I do enjoy it. I think that I think it's a really cool product. Like, yeah. No, Tech, you're right. Like, you can't make a 100% realistic. Like, no, I definitely see your point. Yeah, golfing exactly. Hey, Time to Jet. How you doing, man? It's good to see you. I hope you're doing well tonight. Hope you're doing good, man. Yeah, Captain Jack. I mean, that's just flight sim, though. Flight sim wait time can be long, depending. Hey, Duffy. Realism sitting on the ramp for an hour. When trying to fly into New York. True, dude. Yeah, I mean, I haven't done that, Duffy, but... I almost missed my, like, a relatable thing. I almost missed my connecting flight back to Seattle or back to Portland, which connected to Seattle, because of a pilot missing the approach going or having to fly the missed approach at Minneapolis.
Alaska, so I almost
missed the connecting flight. It was almost really bad. I, like, had to sprint across the entire freaking thing. It was bad when I got to Portland or whatever. It was rough.
American 343, contact Oakland Central, 13.2.
Yeah, it was the connecting flight in Portland I had to run through or whatever. Anyway, something like that. You don't want to sim that? Why, Duffy? Sounds fun, man. P3D would be unplayable with that chase plane. Yeah, the default camera is like... Next time someone like says that a game's camera is bad, I'm just going to show them P3D's camera. Yeah, Cessna, the captain sim. So the reason it's $105, it's $75 for like the one engine variant. And then it's like $30 more for the other engine or something stupid. Like they charge more than like the PMDG expansion for the 737 for like one engine variant. It's kind of fucking dumb. Like, and you're like, well, what do you mean? You buy PMDG and it's, you know, $135 for the 747. Yeah, but it's the only, like, really good 747, really. So it's not the same. Like, there's already a 757 by Flight Factor that's not, you know, that's pretty good. So, and it doesn't cost $105. They just redid all the textures for it and it costs less. And it has the freighter, it has all three variants or whatever, too. The 2-3 and freighter or whatever, the 752 753 in the freighter. Old Tech, yeah, you might. I kind of see what you mean. Hey, Road Rage, how you doing? Some of my most wow, I finally caught up with the chat. Some of my most epic ultra long hauls have been in the 78 789. I've done LAX Sydney. Yeah, that makes sense. I just couldn't stream that, Jack. It just feels like a drag, you know? Hey, no worries, golfing. Take care. Thanks so much. I appreciate you stopping in tonight, friend. Yeah, the sharklets, I get you on that. That makes sense. How much is the paid aircraft toilet mod? Oh, like a lavatory that you simulate? That would be so memes, though. Well, no, that's freaking, yeah.
Alaska 2050, descend at pilot's discretion, maintain flight level 240.
Right, pilot's discretion on flight level 240, Alaska 2050. Alright, so we don't need to do that right now. But we'll do it in a little bit. We're getting there, guys. We're on the way. P3D has rails? True. True.
American 343, contact local approach 119.2.
You were going on a German ICE train and you got on the complete opposite of the train? Oh gosh, that sounds bad. PMDG branded piss jugs. Yeah, for the 748 release. Alright, Mike, talk to him for me. Let him know. I want PMDG piss jugs.
Greening altimeter 3002.
Call Randazzo for me. I need my piss jug, so I'm pronto. Can you call him Daz? Oh, no, Seth. Yeah, I'll call him Daz. Alright, Daz. You're Daz now. One tap on the brakes. So, Daz, basically, X-plane ground handling, but worse. Although, I will give... So, you just reminded me of something. So... I don't have like a ton of experience with this plane yet, but something I will give Flight Factor credit for additionally, the A320 feels like, despite X-plane ground handling, that it feels pretty good actually. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it feels like it gets over some of that. I don't know, like, if that makes sense, but that's what I see anyway. I see this, like, you know, I just see that it feels like it's very, you know, there. This feels right. All right, let me get the descent data here. Let's get the
weather.
So.
November 143 Victor Tango Delta Center, IFR cancellation received. Thank you. Have a good night.
Going to Casper, right? So the altimeter is 2993. Oh, I forgot you have to type the dot in the flight factor.
American 343, descend and maintain 13,000.
Excuse me. All right, temperature is 23 degrees. Magnetic wind is 230 at 8. And that looks fine. So we'll go back. I forgot you can't arrow through that. You have to do that. Okay. So yeah, once, so I set, so it was 240. We're not gonna do that now, but we'll do it soon. All right, where was I? Only when his weekly Playboy mags come in. All right, yep. That's why I don't stream Wednesday, you got me. It's good, but the brakes don't grab enough yet. Medium brake in an A320 is aggressive. The sim doesn't do that. Oh, really? Time to jet? Yeah, I mean, I'm saying, oh, really, as in, like, you know, that's interesting. Obviously, you know more than I know. Reason to fly. What's going on? How you doing?
Eclipse 129, not Quebec, sounds equivalent to Quebec, standby.
Magnitude? What did I miss?
American 343, cross spoon, ETO above 1,000, clear ILS.
Oh, that was a joke about the putting in the wind. And it just went over my head. Which is very possible, to be fair. Ooh, it is dark, boys. It is dark. D-A-R-K right now. All right. Probably going to make it not night anymore when we get into Casper or whatever. Yeah, medium is like bad weather, short runway. Okay. Are you implying that like the fact that I'm using medium makes sense because it's not braking enough on the low setting? Is that what you're getting at? That's what I feel like you're saying, but maybe not. Like you're saying that the reason that you have to use medium in the flight factor is because... Oh, you're saying low is modeled correctly, but medium needs to be better? Okay. Yeah, I was using medium time ago because I felt like it was
a little.
I mean,
maintain 3,000. Expect 9,000 5 minutes after departure.
So you're saying that the stopping power of the Airbus is like better IRL than
okay.
Yeah, it's cool to have like real world feedback like that. You know, I mean, where else are you gonna get that? Real men exit on B. Oh no. Real men exit on B. First turn off or bust. A little bit. Alright, we're gonna let ATC know we're descending. Salt Lake Center, Alaska 2050 is at a flight level 350.
Alaska 2050,
roger. Alright. Real men exit before the 1,000-foot markers. See, that's what I do, Duffy. That's what I do, man. What are you saying? All right, you can say it. I'll take the praise. Okay, it's fine. I'll take the compliment. It's okay, man. That means landing on the piano. Oh. Well, thought you meant like, you know, the 1,000-foot warning before the end of the runway. Well, but Duffy, I mean, yeah, you can stop in 1,000 feet, but not in a, not in like what, freaking, not this. I mean, come on, tell me how you do that. Like stall the thing, and then it seems dangerous. Real Sheldon's, true, but I'm not real Sheldon because Sheldon doesn't do this. If you can land soft enough, you can land on the displaced threshold or the EMAS. I'm tilted. All right, EMAS is not good. If you didn't see the cap, he's not joking. Don't do that. Or he's joking. Don't do that. Don't land on the EMAS, guys. This is not good. Real men land on EMAS. Yeah, then they get fired. Feels good. Then they get fired. Wait, I just thought about something. Does Flight Sim like ever model EMAS or no? I just realized that. It doesn't seem like it does, right? Why doesn't that happen? Why doesn't like, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I just haven't done it. Why don't we have like EMAS simulation? I mean, it's not like it's not there. Like, it's not like it's not visualized. Wait, Memphis has an EMAS in it? Oh, really? You're saying some payware airports do time to check? Okay.
I didn't realize that.
But yeah, like, I think that's kind of a cool little bonus, right? So EMAS is, I believe it's engineered mass arresting system, something like that. Basically what it does though, is when you overrun the runway, it's designed to stop the aircraft. It's very expensive. It's like a last resort to like save the plane. But yeah, it's basically a last resort to save the plane engineered into the end of the runway. Chili has experience, not with EMASs. Come on. All right. All right. I see what you're doing. Come on now.
American 343, contact Reno Tower.
And EMAS has been used, just not very much. Like, overall, obviously. Like, it's a super emergency thing. Realman stall MD-80 and land. Christian, come on. No. EMAS helps prevent Southwest from having a gas station monopoly.
American 343, Reno Tower, good evening. Right. Runway 34 left, quick to land.
You would know, Sabrina, you would know. Excuse me, dudes. My bad. Chili sleep. Cut my life into pieces. EMAS is my last resort. Yeah. Something like that. Something like that, Kev. Something like that, friend. I was behind chat for a while. You guys did really good, so thanks. I do appreciate that. Yeah, however that song goes, yeah. I know what you're talking about. Wait, what, Tech? Did I not hear about that shit? Wait, what? Wait, Pence is playing? Wait, what? Are you serious? Wait, how did that even happen in LaGuardia, though?
Well, I've got 2050 contact for Lake Center, 133.25.
3325, less than 2050. I gotta switch. Salt Lake Center, Alaska 2050, flight level 270, descending flight level 240.
Alaska 2050, Salt Lake Center, descended pilot discretion, maintain 15,000, Warland altimeter 2984.
Alright, pilot's discretion on 15,000, 2984, Alaska 2050. I'm gonna type that in 2984.
November Zero Delta Whiskey, contact Portland Approach 118.42.
Holy shit. I didn't hear about that.
November 800 Delta Whiskey, Portland Approach, greening Portland Altimeter 3004.
Okay, this has way less views than I would expect it to. It has 74k views. That's a pretty big deal. I'm surprised it doesn't have more views. I know that's kind of random, but
Alaska 5, if you not consent to greening.
Of course, this video has no views. Also, I need to this new audio setup, I forgot one thing. I'm gonna need to add a source for the couple other things, but yeah, anyway. So I don't have sound. That's why the alert didn't do anything. So my apologies for that. The sub from Captain Jack earlier. So sorry about that sound not coming through. We still saw it, but I gotta fix that tonight. I think that, I mean, I'm just trying to think, like, wait, Tech, what the fuck? What? People are stupid.
One whiskey, Charlie, descend and maintain 14,000. Contact Casper Approach 120.65.
2065 out of 14,000. One whiskey, Charlie.
I thought that was for me. Hey, Captain Jack, I got you in Discord. Make sure you link your Twitch. If you don't know how to do that, let me know, okay? But, make sure you link your Twitch.
Oscar 1125, welcome to Grimmie.
Oh, no, you got it. I got you, dude. Alright, welcome in, Captain Jack. Thanks, dude. Yeah, I got you. I just forced the sync, so you got the roll now. Oh, check my discon. So yeah, this is a direct.
American 340 feature left. Taxi to parking via Juliet Alpha, monitor ground. Have a good night.
So I want like basically like that. Yeah, that should be fine. Is that loud? Felt loud for me.
American 353 original voice proceed as requested.
Also, I did not want to put it. I want to keep manual.
Equipped 581 whiskey Charlie Casper approach. Good evening. Expect the visual approach. Runway 21.
All right, let me get the charts up for Casper guys. Stand by.
Equipped 581 whiskey Charlie. Part of your transmission. Did you check in with the weather? Alaska 2050, contact Casper approach 120.65.
20.65, Alaska 2050. Yeah, I'll be back with Chad in a moment. I gotta talk to approach here. Casper approach, Alaska 2050 is 16-7, descending 15,000. We have Hotel Casper.
Alaska 2050, Casper approach, expect visual approach, runway 21.
Yeah, we'll expect the visual 21, Alaska 2050.
Alaska 2050, fly heading 110, descend and maintain 11,000, vector for approach.
Alright, fly heading 110 and maintain 11,000, Alaska 2050. Thanks for the sellout moment, Christian. Thanks, dude. But yeah, I gotta get this in. I might take shades off for the approach, by the way. Sorry about that. And no worries, Captain. The meal and beverage service from your recliner. That's what I'm saying, dude. That's what you need, man. No worries though, man. Glad you're enjoying the stream, though. Oh, jeez. All right. X-Plane Noob, by the way. X-Plane Noob, by the way, dude.
Eclipse 1 with Chad, radio speed 2210, if unable advice.
X-Plane 210, that works for us. Eclipse 1 with Charlie.
I hit the wrong button. My bad. I hit the flyby button instead of the... Yeah, I hit the wrong one. Oops. Alright, I'm trolling. Trolling, boys. Okay, so descent. Alright, seatbelt sign should be on by now, by the way. Get your asses buckled. Explosive decompression, road rage, oh no. Landing lights on since it's late. And it's almost at 10,000 anyway. Hey, reason to fly. Are we there? We are almost there. We are descending for the approach.
Maintain 12,000 Eclipse 1 Whiskey Charlie.
Oh gosh, Gucci Gang, nice meme. Yeah, yep, it's me, I know. Yeah, you gotta have that Twitch Prime, though. You're gonna put my O2 mask on, but, you know, put your own on first, yeah. As they say, you should put your O2 mask on before... You should put your O2 mask on before helping others. Yeah, I think so, too, Duffy. I'm not karaokeing fucking Gucci Gang. Oh, the Gaiazo link? Oh, yeah, this. Please remove this video. People can use the steel planes. Yeah, feels good. This stream! Take it down! Monka S, hide the freaking, hide the knowledge from me, the real world A320 driver, by the way. You might use it to start the twin engine aircraft in a single button. Oh no. Like, holy, dude, that shit, like, tilts me off the face of the earth. Things that make you not want to stream this anymore. That fake news. Cessna, you're talking about Gucci Gang? I know. So much meaning. 200 IQ song.
Eclipse and Delta Quebec, Roger, change routes to Lake Salinas, direct Victor, Victor 27, Morovay.
Ha heck? This video helped me a lot.
Alaska, 2050, to send and maintain 8,000.
Send and maintain 8,000, Alaska 2050. Alright, I'm gonna start slowing this darn thing down, boys.
Eclipse 1, Whiskey Charlie, to send and maintain 9,000.
Wait, wait, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Send and maintain 9,001, Whiskey Charlie.
Hello? Can we slow down, boys? I should have probably slowed down earlier. It kept me in managed speed at 300 knots that whole time. Jesus, dude, what? Why though? I don't get it. Why would it do that? It seems like the meme. Like, why would I want to do that?
Alaska 2050, flight heading 120.
120, Alaska 2050.
Eclipse 1, Whiskey Charlie, traffic 10 o'clock, 8 miles. Eastbound, converging in A320, descending through 1-1000.
I mean, yep, it's me. That's what they're making it sound like, and it's so far from the truth. That's the problem, right? It's, like, not nearly real. Like, that's the problem I have with it. Like, it would be one thing if you actually reasonably discussed an issue, but to just, like, spew shit that has no factual basis is, like, not okay. I mean, yes, I understand, like, the sun is a meme, but, like, the shit that King 5 was doing on it, too, was just uncalled
for. Alaska 2050, Casper Airport, 2 o'clock and 15 miles, report inside.
In Casper Approach, Alaska 2050, we have the Casper Airport inside.
Alaska 2050, Good Vision Approach, runway 21.
Air code Visual 21, Alaska 2050.
Eclipse 1, Whiskey Charlie's got that Airbus inside.
Alright, guys.
Eclipse 1, Whiskey Charlie, roger, follow the Airbus, clear visual approach, runway 21, number 2.
Alright, following the traffic, clear for the approach 21, number 2, 1, Whiskey Charlie.
We didn't miss drama. No drama,
Eclipse 1, Whiskey Charlie, start slowing down, the Airbus is showing 260 knots over the ground.
Say again, for what, Whiskey Charlie?
Eclipse 1, Whiskey Charlie, start slowing down. The Airbus is showing 250 knots over the ground and decreasing.
Is that bad?
Sorry. Roger, slowing 1, Whiskey Charlie.
Is that bad?
Alaska
bro?
2050, traffic 2 o'clock, 5 miles eastbound, and Eclipse descending through 10,000 has you in sight and will maintain visual separation.
Hey, Roger, thanks. We'll keep the traffic in sight as well, Alaska 2050, thanks. That's pretty cool. Who's flying into Casper with me? Is it someone on the stream? Who is that? Actually, I'm curious now. Okay, we're gonna put spoilers in. We don't want those out anymore. I want them armed though.
Eclipse 19 Delta Quebec, south of the ground, runway 30 left at Delta, taxi via Victor Delta.
There's no localizer, so...
Alaska 2050, contact Casper Tower, 118.3.
18.3, Alaska 2050. Casper Tower, Alaska 2050, visual runway 21. Yeah, Casper.
Alaska 2050, Casper Tower, runway 21, clear to land, wind 220 at Naya.
Alright, 21, clear to land, Alaska 2050.
I've
said this before, but the reason that I can afford Pilot Edge is because of you guys. Like, it's the stuff that, like, you guys supporting the channel is why I can do that. So, yeah. Well, that's what I'm thinking, reason to fly, yeah. Whoa, that was... sounds. Hello? Jeez, dude. Hello? Let's go managed again.
Casper Tower, good evening. Eclipse 9581, Whiskey Charlie, number 2 behind traffic, runway 21 visual.
Eclipse 581, Whiskey Charlie, Casper Tower, good evening, runway 21, clear to land. Wind 220 at 9.
Clear land 21, 1 Whiskey Charlie.
Wait, why are we so fast. It's managed again.
Approaching 2-1.
I gotta focus, boys. Oh, I need to set auto brake. Holy shit.
Flaps, flaps.
YouTube commenters are gonna say centerline next. You watch them.
5,000.
YouTube
feet
commenters,
remaining.
Get them on the latest. You missed bandages. I know it, dude. All right, here we go. What I'm talking about, dude. What I'm talking about. Feels good. Okay. Wait to see if he says something. Not quite clear of the runway. And Casper Tower, Alaska 2050 is off runway 21F4.
Alaska 2050 taxi to parking via Alpha, remain this frequency, have a good day.
Alright, thanks, Alpha. Remain this frequency. Have a great night, LS 2050. Alright. We can taxi the thing. Can someone untime out Reason to Fly? Hey, Reason to Fly. I'll explain what happened there in a second.
Northbound ground 665 Tango.
Just
good
didn't
evening,
want to mess that taxi up, but we did it anyways. We'll fix that.
With information Alpha.
Reason to Fly. While you're new to the stream, I have a link protection in place. Just ask for a permit. Once you're in the stream a couple times, though, it won't apply. It's not sub-only links, it's just Trojan protection, so. Yeah, just,
Northbound
6-2, 6-5,
Tango, Northbound Ground, to Northbound Airport.
But,
Northbound 6, departure.
Put the clip back in chat.
Maintain,
yeah, thanks for clipping the landing, I appreciate
6,
it.
000.
Yeah.
Departure frequency, 101.4. Clock.
Hey, Sim, thank you again for the 5 months, dude. I really appreciate it, Sim. I hope you're doing well. It's good to see you back streaming again recently. If you guys don't know Sim Caesar and you're looking for a GA stream from time to time, give him a follow, please. He's a chill dude. He does some cool stuff.
I actually updated the altitude down to 4,000.
Hey,
I don't know if that got updated.
I'm doing great things. Sorry, I missed you. Hey, Pug Fanic. Give it a minute. Yeah, that's what I'm saying, Pug. Yeah, you just gotta wait for
frequency
the crash.
Frequency was 1-1.4.
Is this the right spot for the terminal? I don't know, man. You know what? You know what? I don't know, man.
Number 6
I think I missed
my minimum vector altitude around
I think I'm on the other. You know, I think I missed it. I think I was supposed to.
Roger that. 6,000.
All right, so we land the plane
like
right, and then we drive around the airport like an idiot.
To North Bend, 6-6-5 Tango.
Cool. Number
6-5
Tango, Roger.
Sounds great. Let's just
number
taxi around the airport.
Delta
like
Whiskey,
idiot.
Contact Seattle Center 126.6.
All right. Yep, it's me. I'm not sure yet. That was really fun. I enjoyed that a lot. It was great, even though we fucked up the taxi. But you know what? That's easily correctable. That's like me. That's what happens when you actually don't make the landing terrible, and then you're excited about it. Then you just don't think about taxiing what direction. I'm also used to taking a left. Like when I land in Seattle, I take a left to go to cargo or whatever. Google Maps? Nah, I got maps. It's in the moment, you know? It's in the moment, dude. Yeah, this is gorgeous. Also, the sim held up very well. We didn't have any loading issues. Really at all. How smooth has the stream been for you guys? Hey, Campfire Kurt. Welcome to the stream. I see you have a TwitchCon badge there. Campfire, I will be at TwitchCon as well. In October, so maybe we can, if you're a fellow flight simmer captain or Campfire Kurt, excuse me, and you want to meet, then you know, whatever. Hey, Stink, I'm not feeding the troll. Are you talking about online? Yeah, online's freaking small text. Online, you ass. Come on, come on, dude. How you doing, Stink? Good to see you, man. But yeah, Kurt, I'm really looking forward to TwitchCon. It should be fun, so, yeah. All right, thanks, yep, it's me. I was wondering if I ever had any, like, frame drops. I dropped 300 frames somewhere, but I don't know where, because I'll have to look in Twitch Inspector later to see what happens. See if it was, like, a internet thing or what. But, so... for me, here's my first impression of the sounds. They really shined on that approach. That was amazing. Like, you could hear the drag from the gear. Like, that was really good. I don't think I've ever heard, like, that good of an impression of, like, wind, like, the sound of the wind drag from, you know what I mean? That was amazing. That was good. Yeah, like, that was great. Like, that's the thing that stood out to me. Oh, yep, it's me. I totally understand, man. Yeah. It would be cool to meet up, but it's all good. I mean, I don't see a reason why I won't be able to go in 2019 either. Yeah, I totally understand. Hey, traffic, watch where you're going. This is my gate. All right, bro? Come on. Brake's hot. I didn't even brake. All right. Alright, I goofed up, apparently. Apparently, my brakes are now hot, and they weren't hot, like, 10 minutes ago. Okay, I don't know what I did wrong there. Oh, well, man, I'll take it. Apparently, my brakes are hot. I don't know. Okay, dude. Sounds good. Chibi Fest? Oh, I did apply for a meet and greet spot, but I don't expect to get it. I only say that because usually bigger partners get that, but I thought, why not try? It doesn't hurt. Forgot to turn active sky to live weather. Oh no, Monkas. Dude, that's the worst. Yeah, you open active sky and you're like, oh no, I clicked. You're like, oh no, I clicked custom weather. Yeah, dude, I've done that. It's so bad. Cause like one time I did it, okay. One time I did that and I was like at Denver and the previous day it was awful, but we did fine. And then I forgot to like change it, like I forgot to fix it. So then we flew out of Denver and I didn't know what was going on. I was like, the METAR says like 310 at 7 and few clouds, like what's going on? And I realized it had static mode on. Yeah, no, yep, it is me. Well, yep, it's me. So TwitchCon is always in that general area though. So regardless, you'll probably not have to travel very far. Like I don't see them moving it. Cause like that's very close to Twitch, right? Does that make sense? It's very close to Twitch, so there's no reason for them to move it out of California. I would not expect them to do that at all. Yeah, TwitchCon's in like Sydney or some shit. Yeah, no way. Although they do Twitch events elsewhere, but TwitchCon is in California. Wow, -76? Is that real? That is amazing. How did I do that? That's not real, right? That's fucking poggers right there. That is solid. All right, it's X-Plane, so it's right. All right, give it to me. It's X-Plane, so it's right. Don't even question. Come on. Don't even put a Omega Lol landing rate in the chat or anything, you know? But actually, landing rates are memes. It's just a thing in flights and people care about for no reason. I just joke about it. I mean, obviously, you don't want like -600, but if you ever go, you're not showering for a week prior, you'll ensure pure stink by rolling in cow manure. You'll invest online. Are you okay, bro? Are you okay online? What is up? You are like, I like you online, I do, but are you okay, sir? Good to see you though, man. Distance doesn't matter though. Oh, yep, it is me. I am looking forward to Orlando. I've never been to Florida, so I'm really looking forward to it because I've never been able to see it. So, you know, now I have a reason to go. Is this like a control seizure? All right. Ooh. All right, let's get this plane going here. Hey, Ben. Yeah, man. I mean, Flight Sim Expo, based on how this year did, it was good. So I fully expect this next one to be great. I have no doubts, honestly. Hey, Death Fudge. Did I miss you? I feel like I did, but maybe not. Maybe my brain. It's this landing, you know? It's good to see you, dude. Hope you're doing good. Anything below -100 makes me feel good. Not good enough. It's such a joke though. Like, that sounds like a good landing actually, to be honest. Oh, okay, Death Fudge. I got it, man. That's right. Yeah, I remember now, dude. That was a good flight. What the heck? So yeah, in case any of you are wondering, because I've been getting asked recently, the schedule for the stream isn't going to really change. The only thing that's going to change that I plan to start earlier. It's either going to be an hour or 2 hours. I don't know yet. More likely an hour earlier, but it might be 2 hours earlier or an hour and a half. I don't know. But I want to start earlier when I go back to school in a couple weeks. I'll be going back to college in a couple weeks, and I'm probably going to start the stream earlier. That's for a couple reasons. One reason is daylight savings time is coming up. The other reason is because it works better for me because Pilot Edge, like I'll be able to do two streams without feeling like it's super late. When is daylight savings? I don't know. Isn't it like Halloween or something? I don't know. That's what it was last year. It wasn't though. Wait, you went off the runway and you got -113. You greased it though. You got that landing rate. So who cares? Use that EMAS. Yep, it's me. Use it. Come on. You gotta use what you're paying for. You know, you gotta use that $2 million EMAS. That shit is expensive. Oh my gosh, you'd be in debt forever. Maybe we may forget. Oh gosh, online. Old memes. Oh, it's November 4th. Oh, you bounce 3 times? All right, then you gotta add them. You gotta add 68, 48, and 113. Okay, that is actually pretty bad. Oh, by the way, a little side note meme. I didn't know this room thing was a thing. So if the subs want to do that, that's up to you. I just added that because it takes like no effort. So yeah, it's kind of like the Discord channel. Don't need a number to tell you a bounce on landing is shit. No, Stink, you do not, sir. No, you were right. You are correct, friend. I would agree with you. I would agree fully. So let me look at the checklist. All right, so we want this. Transponder. Okay. All right. Hey, Cat 3. It's good to see ya. Wow, Cessna, that's... I don't know if that's a compliment or an insult. Is that a compliment or an insult, friend? I don't really know. You tell me. Bounces on landing. Poor passengers. Feels bad, man. True. Yeah, that's not how you say hi back. You're the easy... Yeah. Hello, you're the easiest rating on Pilot Edge. Isn't that great? Doesn't that just make you feel great? That I acknowledge your existence like that? Yeah. I know. I know. I feel the same way. Pretty much. It's kind of like when... Kind of like when I say hello to someone in chat and they're like... And their name is Pax Off. And they make the name... They make the name Pax Off thinking that that's what the problem is with the engine, and it's literally a bug. And I'm like, are you kidding? Hey, what's going on, Fatal? How you doing? You flew all your cat ratings inverted in an extra 300. I believe it, though. I believe it. And I'm with you, too. With you. With you. But yeah, this was a really cool flight. I enjoyed this a lot. I came up with the city pair because there's no Casper in prepared. I mean, yes, this is the scenery gateway Casper. And I was wondering how it would look at night. And actually, like, gotta love that X-plane glow, man. Looks good, man. That is something that even Tomato Shade doesn't do as well as the lighting glow like that. X-plane night lighting is just, like, unbeatable. I mean, yeah, like, Black Marble's a good start. Like, it has more potential. I think that it's a good thing, but there are some things that it needs to do better. I think on-ground lighting needs to be better. I think in the air, Black Marble looks good, but I think that on the ground, it doesn't look that great. Oh, Stink, for sure, man. It is, yeah. PE is, like, super worth. Yeah, I totally agree with that. Also, if you want to catch up, Sting, let me know. Hope your things are good with you, man. Okay. I actually remembered the nav data, but like something else about X-Plane is the interior lighting at night too. It's not just the outside lighting. Like I feel like this inside lighting is super smooth. You never fly with Pilot Edge? Hey, Cat 3, you know what? More power to you, but I would recommend it still. All right, we're going to open the window. Customary chili bonus. All right, we're going to go outside, boy. There you go. Jump! Leave! Uh-oh, I'm stuck. Go! Yeah, I can't jump out here, but, you know. But, yeah, for sure. X-Plane is... really nice. I hate you for opening that window. Yeah, you're welcome. You're welcome, friend. That switch, it's under here. I always do this. It's not the stick. It's like this thing, whatever. It's under... Oh, shoot, whatever. I always forget. I do this every time. I'm just trolling, though. It was just a joke. Yeah, I forgot. I just asked you because I was testing the frames, and I clicked it. So I scrolled it open by accident, and then oh, it's this. No, I got it. It's that. It's this thing, right? Yep, I got it. Okay, it's the little switch you can't see. All right. That was cool. Even though it was night, like, this looks great. So, yeah, anyway. Where was I, guys? You right now? Me right now? Triggered. 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 Yeah, that's a meme right there. Probably should add that to the list, huh? Probably should put that in Discord. Maybe that should be an emote. Chili triggered. Or chili pissed. I don't know. Anyway. So, we're gonna find someone to host here. Yeah, we're gonna find someone to host here, guys. But I seriously want to thank you for coming out tonight. I hope you enjoyed the A320 stream. Hope you enjoyed the visual approach memes and not actually going around and greasing it and being awesome, because the chat was amazing tonight. I enjoyed it. So you guys were awesome. Great audience tonight. You guys are fantastic. I am very grateful for you. Trust me. I am. All right. As not serious as that sounds, because I talk in a non-serious tone. You guys know that? All right. Who are we throwing it to? Do you guys want to see 727 Ninja is live? Yeah, I'll go get more fucking view boss. That sounds good. I could host Sandy, but I don't think you guys want to watch shooters. I don't think that's what I want to do. With all due respect, I think Flight Sim is more relevant to what I do. I like Sandy, but he's a cool guy. It's nothing about that at all. Okay. He doesn't have sub alerts? Yeah, he does. You're trolling. Sandy Ravage? Yeah, he does. I was just watching his stream yesterday. What are you talking about? Yes, I landed, Duffy. I greased. You know what? Actually, wait, I'm an idiot. I'm sorry. Let's replay the landing. I forgot this is X-Plane and it'll actually sound good. My bad. I'm so silly. Okay, let's do this then. I'm sorry. Why didn't anyone say anything? I feel so terrible. All right. Let's come in for this shit. Where is this? Okay. All right. Yeah, we were a little high coming in, Duffy, but we made up. Or actually, not really. I mean, yeah. Okay, this might be really loud. Why is there no volume, though? What happened? Hello? Why is it muted? Did I mute it? Is that a bug? What? Where's my sound? Hello? What did I do? Is it the sound pack? Wait, it doesn't have sound on replay? Oh my god. All right, 0 out of 10. That's depressing. I was like, we need to replay the landing. And then like, are you kidding? This is trolling though. Like I don't even get to listen to my like porn though, you know? Come on. All right, well, we'll replay it anyway, but that's unfortunate. Is that gonna be added though? Like, what do they like that? Maybe I'm being a little harsh, but is that gonna be added? Because that's kind of lame, I would say. Make the noises with your mouth. Yes, you want me to ASMR it like this? What? I don't fucking know how to do that shit. I'm not an ASMR streamer. All right. I'm not an ASMR streamer, so, you know. Oh, it's like I'm actually there. I'm tilted. It's like I'm actually there. Feels good. But this is actually so smooth. Look at that. Look at that professional. Professional. Chili, don't stop. Hey, Doom Diver. What's going on? Like, no. Like, no. Okay, that's, like, so slow, though. How do I, like, not go set slow? I want to go, like, faster than that. It's so slow. Oh my gosh, dude, he's doing it. He's doing it. He did it, dude. Yeah, something like that, Brian. Yeah, that is pretty cool, though, actually, not gonna lie. This night lighting, though. This lighting. My immersion, dude. My immersion. I'm immersed. Other than Alaska at Casper, I'm immersed. All right. Yeah, I got to give the crowds what they want. All right, guys. Thank you again so much for being awesome as always tonight. Thanks for the support. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being in chat. Thanks for joining our Discord server. Thank you for the subs and resubs and everything. You guys are awesome. I appreciate you. You should expect a flight tomorrow. I don't have any reason right now why I won't be on. But yeah, guys. Thank you very much. Go say hi to Torb for me, guys. We're going to go say hi to Torb. He's flying the 727. It's pretty cool. Hopefully you enjoy it. Go say hi to Torb for me. If you want to put some shades in the chat, you just do it. Do that. He's a good dude. All right. Have a great night, guys. Keep being awesome, and I'll see you tomorrow night. Take care. Later.